Welcome to Digital Learning DCE. I am Suguna, working as Assistant Professor at GFGC Chintamani. In this video, I am presenting the BSc Third Semester Mathematics Algebra Paper 3, Properties of Order of an Element of a Group, Theorem 6. Let A be an element of order n of a group G, and let P be an integer prime to n, then A power of P is also of order n. Proof. Given order of A is equal to n, let order of A power of P is equal to m, which implies that A power of P whole to the power of m is equal to E by the definition of order of an element of a group. Clearly, order of A power of P is less than or equal to order of A, that is, M is less than or equal to N. Consider this as equation 1. And also, P and N are relatively prime, which implies that there exist integers X and Y such that NX plus PY is equal to 1. A power of nx plus py is equal to a power of 1 because nx plus py is equal to 1. This implies a power of nx into a power of py is equal to a. This implies a power of n whole power of x into a power of py. Just we have taken a power of nx as a power of n whole to the power of x and a power of py as it is. A power of n whole power of x, a power of py is equal to a. It implies that a power of n whole power of x into a power of py is equal to a. Because a power of n is equal to e, so a power of n whole power of x is written as e power of x. E power of x into a power of py is a. Consider a power of m is equal to a power of py whole power of m, because we got here a power of py as a, so replace a by a power of py, and rearranging the powers we get a power of p whole power of m whole to the power of y. A power of P whole power of E, we get E power of Y. E power of Y is nothing but E. So this implies order of A is less than or equal to M. Order of A means it is N. So this can be written as N is less than or equal to M. Consider this as equation 2. By 1 and 2, we get M is equal to N. Because equation 1 implies m is less than or equal to n, and equation 2 implies n is less than or equal to m. Hence, from 1 and 2, m is equal to n. That is, order of A is equal to order of A power of P. Now, order of A is equal to n, and order of A to the power of P is m. Hence, the result. Now, theorem 7. Statement, let A be an element of order n of a group G, and let P be an integer such that n, P is equal to D. Then prove that order of A power of P is equal to n by D. Proof. Given order of A is equal to n, so n, P is equal to D. Given order of A is equal to n, given order of A is equal to n, and n, P is equal to D. This implies D divides n and D divides P. Means D is the common divisor of both n and P. This can be written as n is equal to dk1 and P is equal to dk2. Okay, here we have taken some constants k1 and k2. So, k1 and k2 are relatively prime. Let order of a power of p is equal to m, which implies a power of p whole power of m is equal to e, that is A power of PM is equal to E. A power of PM is equal to E implies that N divides PM, which implies DK1 divides DKM. Because N is equal to DK1, P is equal to DK2. So by substituting those values, we get DK1 divides DKM. So D and D get cancels. Then we get K1 by K2 M implies K1 divides M. Treat this as equation 1. Now consider A power of P whole to the power of K1. Now by rearranging the powers, A power of K1 whole power of P is equal to A power of K1 whole to the power of, in the place of P substitute DK2. Then A power of DK1 whole power of K2, it can be written like this. Then A power of DK1 is nothing but N. So we get A power of N whole power of K2. Now A power of N is equal to E. Therefore A power of N whole to the power of K2 is E power of K2, which is equal to E, which implies M divides K1. Treat this as equation 2. Now by equation 1 and 2, M is equal to K1. Because K1 divides M and M divides K1 means both of them are equal. Therefore, M is equal to N by D, that is order of A power of P is N by D. Now let us work out few examples based on this. Let G be a group, A comma B are any two elements of G of order M and N respectively. Then order of AB less than or equal to order of A into order of B. Let us find out the solution for this. Given order of A is equal to M and order of B is equal to N. Now consider AB to the power of MN, which is equal to A power of MN into B power of MN. A power of MN can be written as A power of M whole to the power of N, and B power of MN is B power of N whole power of M. Now by the data, we know that order of A is equal to M, order of B is equal to N. Therefore, A power of M is equal to E, B power of N is equal to E. So we get E power of N into E power of M, which is equal to identity element E. This implies that order of AB is less than or equal to MN. N is order of A and M is order of B. So which is less than or equal to MN means that is equal to order of A, order of B. Hence the result. Another example 2. Let G be a group and A comma B are any two elements of G of order M and N respectively. If M and N are relatively prime, show that order of AB is equal to order of A into order of B. So given order of A is equal to M and order of B is equal to N. Now let order of AB is equal to K. Consider AB to the power of MN. AB to the power of MN can be written as A power of MN into B power of MN. Just like a previous example, it is A power of M whole power of N, B power of N whole power of M, that is equal to E, which implies that K divides MN. Treat this as equation 1. Now order of AB is equal to K implies AB to the power of K is equal to E by the definition of order of an element. AB to the power of K is A power of K into B power of K, that is equal to E, which implies A power of K is equal to B power of minus K. Since the product of two elements is equal to E means one will be the inverse of the other. Implies order of A power of K is equal to order of B power of minus K. And that implies order of A power of K is equal to order of B power of K. Order of A power of K divides order of A, and order of B power of K divides order of B. That is nothing but order of A power of K divides M and order of b power of k divides n. But order of a power of k is equal to order of b power of k. Therefore, order of a power of k divides m and n both, which implies that order of a power of k divides mn, which is equal to 1, which implies a power of k is equal to e and b power of k is equal to e. But order of a is equal to m and a power of k is equal to e, both of these results implies that m divides k. And also we have order of b is equal to n and b power of k is equal to e, which implies n divides k. M divides k and n divides k, since mn are relatively prime, implies mn divides k. Take this as equation 2. Now from 1 and 2, k is equal to mn, that is order of ab is equal to order of a into order of b. Thank you.